Operation Mortimer, the 30th anniversary of the murders of Seamus and Danny. Last year, we planted trees in this spot, and we needed a couple of big memorials, but we didn't know much about trees. We didn't know it was a bad time of the year to plant them, and one of them didn't survive. So we replanted one of the trees last week, and the families felt very strongly there was a need to make clear what this memorial was about. And so it's been fenced in, and it's kind of unbelievable because the work only started today. We fenced it in, and then a plaque, which is up here, which we'll go up and read later. What I'm basically going to do is just read a couple of words from my right here. We're going to have a moment of silence for the team. Remember, how should we be acknowledged? How do we remember if we've got no memory? How do we acknowledge if we've got no knowledge? What happened on the 31st of July, 1972 in Derry? What happened on the 31st of July, 1972 in Dragon Street? What happened between 4 and 5 a.m. in Cregan Heights when Danny was shot at almost point-blank range by a soldier police using a general-purpose machine gun? Danny was accompanied by his cousins Christopher and Thomas, who are here tonight. Christopher was also shot and wounded. What happened between 4 and 5 a.m. in the Bishop's Beat? And what happened outside number 3, Lensford Drive? Were so brave, claimed to have fired 4 shots at Seamus Bradley, the alleged gunman, where forensic and ballistic tests showed that he had not been carrying any weapon. What happened in the time between Seamus was shot and when his body was brought to St. Peter's School in a Saracen? What happened to the investigation into those deaths? Why did the Director of Public Prosecutions direct no prosecution of Soldier B for the murder of Danny Hegarty, or Soldier A, and very possibly others, for the murder of Seamus Bradley? Well, that's one question we can't know the answer to. There was no prosecution. The people that died, the victims, were working class, Catholic, and Irish. They lived in Cregan, and therefore they were guilty. Some of the other questions we now know the answer to. So we can begin to remember and to acknowledge that we've got some memory and some knowledge. Just as we are beginning to understand what happened only 100 yards from here, in this spot, where Thomas Green was killed on 22nd May 1973 by a plastic bullet fired by Soldier Pickett, according to his inquest afterwards. Are we beginning to understand what happened to Captain Thompson, or Manus Deer, or Jim Gallagher, or Stephen McConaughey, just to name a few of the many people where there are still questions? Recovering the memory and the knowledge is like putting together a jigsaw. It takes time. It's frustrating.
Can I just step back a step, folks?